In this video, we're going to discuss the four different types of audit opinions. So every year, a company is going to hire an auditor to come in and express an opinion regarding its financial statements. That opinion could be unqualified, it could be qualified, it could be an adverse opinion, or it could be a disclaimer of opinion. I want to go through each of these in turn and explain what it means. So an unqualified opinion is actually the best opinion from the perspective of the company that's being audited. You also call it a clean opinion. And what it is the auditor is saying, look, we've looked at the financial statements and the accompanying notes, and we believe that they are presented fairly. We believe they're presented in accordance with GAAP, generally accepted accounting principles, and we don't believe there are any material misstatements, okay? When I say material, it's saying that, look, the revenue might be off by $10. That's not material. It's not a big deal. But we've looked at the statements. We don't believe there's any material misstatements. And it's reasonable assurance. It's not a guarantee. That opinion will appear after the company's financial statements in its annual report. Okay, so that's the best thing. That's what most companies get. They get a clean audit opinion. However, there could be different types of opinions. It's not always going to be an unqualified opinion. And now a qualified opinion is saying, look, we have examined, from the perspective of the auditor, we have examined the financial statements and they are presented fairly. They are presented in accordance with GAAP, except for one thing, right? There's some single issue, right? There's a single departure from GAAP where maybe that company didn't account for their inventory in accordance with GAAP. And so they say, okay, everything was fine with the financial statements except for the way they did their inventory. And so they would mention that. Or if there was a single scope limitation. For example, if the company wouldn't let, or for some reason the auditor wasn't able to count the inventory. It could be that the company wouldn't let them, or there was some issue with the circumstances. And for whatever reason, there was just this one scope limitation. It's not that the auditor couldn't even do the entire audit. They did the audit, there was just a single issue, and so we say that it's qualified in the sense that, okay, everything is fine except for. So the qualification is either that single departure from GAAP or that scope limitation. Okay, if there's a more serious scope limitation where the auditor can't even do the audit, we'll talk about that in a moment. Okay, now an adverse opinion is basically the opposite of a clean opinion. The auditor has looked at the financial statements and they're coming in and saying, look, they are not presented fairly. They are not presented according to GAAP. We cannot give you reasonable assurance that there are no material misstatements here because it looks like there are material misstatements. So this is a bad thing. A company does not want an adverse opinion. It's basically saying that your financial statements are not reliable, that an investor should look at that and not be able to trust that information. Now, a disclaimer of opinion is, in a sense, I mean, we said there's four different types of opinions, but really, it's the auditor is not expressing an opinion. They're saying, look, we cannot express an opinion. And there are several reasons that the auditor might say, okay, we have to do this disclaimer of opinion. One is if the auditor lacks independence. Now, you might be thinking, why would the company hire the external auditor to begin with if they knew that they lacked independence? Well, the thing is that they might have had independence at the beginning of the audit when they were hired, but then something happened that changed that. Let's just say, for example, that the CEO of the audit firm ended up marrying the CEO of the company being audited, okay, during the audit process. Then the auditor would have to say, hey, look, we lack independence now. We're no longer independent. So we're just going to have to issue a disclaimer of opinion, and the company would go and hire a different auditor. Okay. Now, if there's an extensive scope limitation, and again, this is different from the qualified opinion where we say, oh, there was this one thing. We weren't able to do this one thing. But other than that, the financial statements look pretty good. If there's an extensive scope limitation where basically the auditor is saying, look, we weren't able to do our job. We weren't even really able to conduct this audit. So we can't express an opinion. It could be, again, that the management was preventing them and that from looking at things like counting the inventory, and that's the reason for the scope limitation. Or it could just be something with the circumstances and it wasn't actually management or the company's fault. But in any case, there was a huge scope limitation and the auditor is not able to express an opinion. So then they would come out and just say, look, here's a disclaimer. We can't actually express an opinion on these financial statements. And then also, if there's substantial uncertainty For example, let's say the company is being sued for a massive amount of environmental liabilities that they might have, and there's just really a lot of doubt about what are these liabilities going to be and how to if there's just some uncertainty where the auditor says, look, we really can't express an opinion here. It wouldn't be right to do so. Or if there's doubt about the company's ability to continue as a going concern. And when I say going concern, I mean, is the company still going to be around a year from now? Or are they going to go bankrupt? Now, you can actually have, this is a little misleading with this going concern as for the disclaimer of opinion, because what actually happens more often when you have a going concern issue and there's doubts about, is the company go bankrupt or whatever? So then in a lot of cases, you'll actually have where the auditor issues an unqualified opinion, assuming that the financial statements are otherwise presented fairly. They'll give an unqualified opinion, and then they'll add an extra paragraph to that unqualified opinion that says, okay, look, yes, the financial statements are presented fairly, but we have doubts about the company's ability to continue as a going concern. But if the auditor has just really serious problems and just says, look, we don't even know, maybe we don't even think this company's going to be in business next week. In such a case or something where there's just serious doubt, they have the right to just say, look, we're not, we can't express an opinion here on the company's financial statements.